most innocent and unlikely of places.
Check on, oh my God! Oh, Audrey! Where did you get that shiner?
Shiner?
Audrey, that greasy boyfriend of yours, he's been beating you up again. Look, I know it's none of my business, but I'm starting to think maybe he's not such a nice boy.
You don't meet nice boys when you live on Skid Row, Mr.
Mushnick. I got these plans to pot up with Mr. Mushnick.
Seymour! Look what you've done to the inventory!
Did Seymour, Mr.
Mushnick? Hi, Audrey. You look radiant today. Is that new eye makeup?
I'll help him clean it up before any of the customers get here.
Oh, well, that ought to give you plenty of time. Look, God, what an existence I've got. Misfit employees, bums on the sidewalk, business is lousy. My life is a living hell. Hey, you, Archie! Archie's off the stoop! Come on, buddy. It ain't bad enough now, so they got the vinyls permanently decorating the storefront, huh?
Somebody say I'll get out of here. Someone give me my shot, or I'll rot.
And they didn't sell so much as a fern! I guess this is it. Don't bother coming into work tomorrow.
You don't mean...
Oh, you can't mean...
But, what don't I mean? I mean I'm finished. Forget it. Kaput!
You can't.
Kaput! I'm closing this garden. Customer for second place.
Mr. Moshnik, forgive me for saying so, but has it ever occurred to you that maybe what the firm needs is to move in a new direction?
What Sue was trying to say, Mr. Mushnik, we've talked about it and we both agree. Seymour, why don't you run back and bring out that strange and interesting plant you've been working on?
But I haven't been able to identify it in any of my books. So I gave it my own name. I call it an Audrey 2.
After me?
Oh, I hope you don't mind. You see, sir, if you put a strange and an interesting plant like this up. Oh, here in the window. Maybe, but.
Do you have any idea how ridiculous you sound? Just because you put a strange and interesting plant in the window, people don't suddenly just bolt in it.
Excuse me, I couldn't help noticing that strange and interesting plant in the window. What is it?
It's an Audrey 2.
Well, I've never seen anything like it before.
No one has.
Where did you get it?
Well, you remember that total eclipse of the sun a couple weeks ago?
Huh.
I was walking in the wholesale flower district that day. And I passed by this place where this old Chinese man, he sometimes sells me weird and exotic cuttings. Because he knows, you see, strange plants are my hobby. He had nothing there unusual that day. And I was about about to, you know, walk on by.
Good for you.
When suddenly, and without warning, there was this total eclipse of the sun. It got very dark, and then I heard this weird humming sound like something from another world. The light came back.
This weird plane was just sitting there, just stuck in, you know, among the zinnias. I could have sworn it hadn't been there before, but the old Chinese man sold it to me anyway, for $1.95.
I might as well take $50 worth of roses while I'm here.
$50?
$50?
$50? Yes, sir. Right away, sir. Right away.
Well, can you break 100?
100!
Oh, no. No. Yes, we closed the register.
Take twice as many then.
Twice as many.
Twice as many?
Yes, sir. Come right away, sir. Audrey, dearest, my love, Audrey, would you please get this fine gentleman $100 worth of our finest red American beauty roses?
Yes, sir, that is one strange and interesting plant.
Quick, why are you just standing there? So put the plant up, what do you call it?
Oh, and then Audrey, too.
Audrey, too, in the window where passersby can see it. My God, I never have believed it.
My children, I'm taking us all out to dinner.
Oh, I'd love to, Mr. Mushnik. But I have a date.
A date? Audrey? This that sad, no good Nick boyfriend of yours? Audrey, you don't need a date with him. He needs major medical. He ain't a good, clean kind of boy.
He's a professional.
Ah, what kind of professional rides around on a motorcycle and wears a black leather jacket?
Well, he's a rebel, Mr. Mushnik, but he makes good money.
Yeah. Not going anywhere, Krellborn. You're staying here and taking care of this sick plant. How come it's fainting all the time?
I told you, it's been giving me trouble. It just wilts like this. The Audrey 2 is not a healthy girl.
Strictly between you and me, neither is the Audrey 1.
If only I knew what breed it is, or what gene is, but nowhere in the books.
Well, my advice to you, Krellborn, is to figure out and fast. Look what that little beauty did for business.
Oh, I know.
You do? So work. Nurse that little plant, that helps. I'm counting on you, Seymour.
I know.
You do?
I do.
So fix! Good night.
Oh, Chewie. Mr. Mushnik and Audrey, they just met you, but I've been going through this for weeks. Grow and wilt, spurt and flop. Are you sickly little plant or just plain stubborn? What is it you want? What does he need?
I've given you sunshine. I've given you dirt. You've given me nothing but heartache and hurt. I'm begging you sweetly. I'm down on my knees. Your plant food and nothing to sip. I've given you potash, you've given me zip. Oh God, how I miss you. Oh, but how you tease. Now please grow for me. I've given you southern exposure to get you to thrive. I've pinned you back hard like I'm supposed to. You're barely alive. I've tried you at levels of moisture, from desert to mud.
I think I know what made you do that. Well, I guess a few drops couldn't hurt as long as you don't make a habit out of it or anything.
I'm giving you sunlight. I'm giving you rain. Looks like you're not happy.
Bye.
hearts of our little shop, and then tomorrow we'll be open again.
Aren't you finished yet?
Bill, I'm doing my best. But all these bad things make it kind of hard. I know it seems like every time I pick up a fruiting shears, I slip.
Full renovation, goes farming down and brewing, cause business has been thriving, since our creatures been blooming. The phones have not stopped ringing with the customers who say, what about a bunch of peonies? Geraniums and anemones. The trophies from the liberties on Twitter.
Very bad shopper, Audrey. I don't have good taste like you.
Well, I could help you pick things out sometime.
You could?
Well, sure.
You go shopping with me.
Sure.
You'd be seen with me in a public place like a department store.
Well, sure.
Tonight?
I bet you got a lot of dates now, huh?
Oh, well, not dates exactly, but a lot of gardening clubs have been calling, asking me to give lectures.
Gee?
Imagine me giving lectures. I never even finished grade school. Some experience. I don't even know what it's like to fly in an airplane.
Oh, me neither.
Or eat fancy dinner down at Howard Johnson's.
Oh, me neither.
Or ride a motorcycle.
Oh, it's no big deal. And besides, it's dangerous.
It is?
Extremely dangerous.
I'm afraid that information will cost you. is. I'm friendly. Truth, Pacha. Want some nitrous oxide?
Well, don't you get lost, Vitalis Brains. The last thing Audrey needs is more of your kind.
My kind is a very nice kind. I'm not a monster.
What else would you call it?
I would call it a... I would call it an occupational hazard.
Say, what?
You see, girls, my line of work requires a certain fascination with human pain and suffering. This stuff is great. Allow me to explain. When I was younger, just a bad little kid, my mama noticed funny things I did, like shooting puppies with a BB gun. I'd poison guppies, and when I was done, I'd find a pussycat and bash it in its head. That's what my mama said.
What did she say?
She said, my boy, I think someday you'll find a way to make your natural tendencies pay. He'll be a dad.
Excuse me,
that's better.
kid. This thing is a big green gold mine. You get your ass out of here and you take the plant with you.
What?
Mushnik Skid Row florist. It's like a joke. You hear me talking to you?
I hear you.
Yes. Shouldn't we be leaving? I'm sorry.
Sorry what?
Sorry, doctor. Doctor, I'm sorry, doctor.
You gotta train a mace, Todd. Well, my bike's outside and double parked, so I guess I'd better be leaving, but you think about what I said, Scout?
Sure. I'll think about it.
You'll think about it.
You do that. Okay, Audrey. You got the handcuffs?
They're right in my bed.
Well, then let's go.
You'll think about it.
I don't like that guy, Mr. Mushnik. You should hear the way he talks to Audrey.
God, the little dog, the kid just said she was all over.
No wonder she looks so unhealthy. It's enough to make you sick.
If you left me, if Seymour left me, why then I'd be like that very stuff,
which was growing zombie.
Sweet and good and beautiful as she is, she deserves a prince, not a sadistic creep like him.
What a bankrupt.
What a louse.
He's a befuddled when we left. That's what I'd be if Seymour left.
He's a disgrace to the dental profession.
Seymour!
Yes, sir.
Seymour! How would you like to be my son? How would you like to be my own adopted boy? I never liked him much before, but count the cash that's in the drawer. I've got no choice, I'm much too poor.
Say yes!
What for?
Seymour, I want to be your dad. I want to see you climbing up my family tree. I used to think you left the stench, but now I see that you're a man, so I'm proposing be my son.
Thanks a million for making the magic you do. Thanks to you, sweet petunia. Mushnik's taking a junior. And someday when I own this whole shop, I'll remember I owe it to you. Oh, Chewie, who cares if I've been a little on the anemic side these past few weeks? So what if I've had a few dizzy spells? A little lightheadedness. It's been worth it, old pal. Well, I'm a little hungry. I'm gonna run down to Schmendrick's and get a bite to eat. I'll see you in the morning. Oh boy, here we go again. Look, Tui, I haven't got much left. Just give me a little more time to heal, and then we'll start again on the left hand, and from there we
can... Feed me!
I beg your pardon?
Feed me!
Oh, Chewie! You talked? You opened up your trap, your thing, you said feed
me! Feed me, Grubhorn, feed me now.
But I can't!
I'm starving!
Oh boy. Well, maybe I can squeeze a little more to this one, but I don't know if this...
I need some food!
I know, but you can't get blood from a person...
More!
I haven't got any more. Well, what do you want me to do? Slit my wrists? Look. How about I run down the corner and give you some fresh chopped sirloin?
Must be blood.
Chewie, that's disgusting.
Must be fresh.
Oh, I don't want to hear this.
Feed me.
Does it have to be human?
Feed me.
Does it have to be mine?
Feed me.
But where am I supposed to get it?
Easy boy. Feed me all night long. That's right, boy. I'll make it worth your while.
What?
You think this is all a coincidence, baby? The sudden success around here, your adoption paper?
Look, you're a plant, an inanimate object.
Does this look inanimate to you, punk? If I can talk, and I can move, who's to say I can't do anything I want? Like the little pal. Like to see you get everything your secret, greasy heart desires. When you like a Cadillac car, or a cash out on jackpot, how are they related to mine? You're gonna get it.
I'd
like to be a big wheel, lining out for every meal. Find the bread we can make it all real. You're gonna get it. I'm your genie, I'm your friend.
Money, girl. one particular girl. How about that Audrey? Think it over.
There must be someone you can hate in six real quiet life and get me some love!
We'll start with that wisdom, too.
Oh, no, no, no. We'll just rip that bugger right out of there. What you say? I gotta go.
There's always time for dental hygiene, Seymour. Have you ever seen the results of a neglected mouth?
Oh, oh! Look, Seymour! It's back!
I'd take immediate action. Let's get started.
Oh, wait, aren't you gonna give me Novocaine first?
What for? Dulls the senses.
But it'll hurt.
Only until you pass out.
What's that?
A drill, Seymour.
It's rusty.
It's an antique. They don't make instruments like they used to anymore. Sturdy, heavy, dull. This is gonna be a challenge. This is gonna be a pleasure. I'm gonna want some gas for this one.
Gas?
Nitrous oxide.
Oh, thank God. I thought you weren't gonna use any gas.
Oh, no. The gas isn't for you. It's for me. I wanna really enjoy this, you see. A little giggle gas before I begin increases my pleasure enormously. In fact, I'm gonna use my special gas mask. Oh, just relax, Seymour. I'll be with you in a moment.
Are you satisfied? I'm the last elf to She's real pretty.
Oh, that's perfect.
thank you. Here you go. Here, goodbye now.
Must we get something you hold? See what can help with these bones? Your favorite floor, can you hold?
Mushy gets on the skidoo favorite floors. Can you hold, please?
Now you were saying. Flowers for our prentice.
The flowers for an entourage.
Flowers for the funeral home.
Leaving from St. Andrew's Roman Catholic Church in 9th and Vine.
$40 hold the line.
Oh, first thing in the morning.
Fine.
There in the morning.
And you hold.
Down in the dumps ever since his mysterious disappearance. You miss him, don't you?
Miss him? I never felt so relieved as when they told me he'd vanished. It was like a miracle. Not to mention all the money I've saved on Epsom salts and eggs bandages.
Then what's the matter?
Thank you.
That's all behind you now. You're a nice person, and I always knew you were. Underneath the bruises, and the handcuffs. You know what I saw? A girl I respected. I still do. Lift up your head, wash off your mascara. You can take my Kleenex. Wipe that lipstick away. Show me your face, clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly, Seymour is standing beside you. You don't need no makeup. Don't have to pretend. Suddenly, Seymour is here to provide you sweet understanding. Seymour's your friend.
Later. I'll call if that's okay. Of course. Good night, Seymour. Good night, Miss Mushnik.
guts all over the floor.
You're acting pretty strange, Pop.
I had a pretty strange afternoon, son. After my lawyer's appointment, I was called down to the police station.
Police?
The police. It seems they made a routine investigation into the disappearance of that motorcycle dentist. And when they did, they found a Mushnik Skid Row florist bag in his office.
What's that supposed to mean?
Exactly what I ask myself, Seymour. And then I begin to think about things I've noticed around here lately. Little red dots all over the linoleum.
I spilled some Hawaiian punch. And it's stained.
Hard to keep things clean around here, isn't it? Especially when they only take our garbage out once a month.
Well, what are you talking about? Where are you going?
If you want something removed in a hurry, it's best not to dispose of it on Skid Row.
What are you talking about?
This! A dentist uniform!
He's got your number now.
I know that this last week, and I don't think twice.
He knows just what you've done.
So the door and ducks, this singing is enough.
You've got no place to hide.
And I can't show kissing the dentist's girlfriend.
You've got nowhere to run.
It begins to look like a motive.
He knows your life of crime.
Once he's out of the way, you move in, right? Of your baseball cap, Seymour! The police found it when they searched Corvello's office. They showed it to me. They asked me if I can identify it!
Did you?
No!
No. They don't suspect you at all, Seymour.
They don't know about the dots. The uniform. The girlfriend.
I didn't do it!
Come with me to the police, and you tell them that!
He's got his facts all straight.
Just so my conscience will rest easy.
You know he's on your trail.
If you don't, I'll have to tell them myself.
He's gonna turn you in.
Now will you come with me?
They're gonna put you in jail.
Okay.
He's USDA for
Seymour!
on now.
Success would come with messiness.
see I'm busy.
Top tip.
Watch your language.
Rawr! Come on, Grandma, read me!
Cut it out. I've got to finish a speech for the lecture tour tomorrow. It's all about you, isn't it? Give me some peace and quiet, or I'll tell them the truth.
Don't get cute with me. I made you, and I can break you.
Go ahead. Break me. You think it's easy living with the guilt?
Oh, cut the crap and bring it on to me!
If only you'd eat meat. If only you touch a mouse or a fly, but no, you're so particular.
Come on, Gregor. Feed me. I ain't eating this woodnick, and that was a week ago.
Look, let's just hold that one more night, can't you? Tomorrow morning, Life magazine will be here to take up pictures, and then I...
And then you'll find me somebody?
And then you'll never be hungry again. I promise.
Chow time, come on! Boo, boo, boo! Feed me! Bring on the grub! Come on, grab on!
Oh, I can't take it much more!
Feed me! Boo,
you're driving me crazy! Now shut up, will you?
Feed me! Feed me!
Czechoslovakia. Right. He could be gone a very long time. Audrey. Can I ask you something?
For anything.
Well, suppose for a minute that there'd never even been an Audrey 2. That I was a nothing again. A nobody. Would you still like me?
I'd still love you, Seymour.
Then it's settled.
What's settled? A gun!
And bullets. And rat poison. And a machete. Tomorrow morning when Life magazine takes our picture, you know who bites the dust!
Seymour!
That's right. We'll snap the photo. We'll be famous. I'll take that TV job. And we'll live a nice, quiet, normal life together. No more night feedings. No more squalling for blood.
Feedings? What blood, Seymour? I don't get it! Bullets, knives, rat poison.
There's nothing to be scared of. We'll go away from here. I'll take you to that little development you always dreamed about. And once we're there, we'll live happily ever after. I promise. Nice little house. Nice little car. And no plants. No plants at all.
You're talking so peculiar, Seymour.
I'll explain everything to you tomorrow. Just go home now, Arthur. Please.
I can't leave you in this condition.
But Don't worry about me. Don't worry about anything.
Feed me!
Under no circumstance.
Feed me!
I will not, so stop asking.
Feed me!
Look, I can't take much more of this. I'll run down the corner and get you some rare roast beef. Maybe that'll hold you over till Life magazine gets here.
No way.
Yes or no?
It's better than nothing.
Done. Fine. Great. And don't think you're getting any dessert.
Made it so big and strong, and he's so famous.
Oh, happened terrible things, Audrey. But not to you. Never to you.
Advertising, this will be bigger than hula hoops.
No shit, Sherlock.
Subsequent to the events you have just witnessed, unsuspecting. in a space in which many of us have lived for 19 years. If you've read the program, you'll know that there have been literally thousands of performances in this box. I want to say something about audiences, though. I did a rough calculation. In a year, we have about 3,000 people who witness major shows and probably another 1,000 who witness concerts and jazz festivals and dance recitals and on and on. If you do the math, that means something like 80,000 people have sat in these chairs and enjoyed performances like this in this box. It's a staggering number. I can't tell you how important you are. You witness, you receive, you share with us, and this is why it matters. We have people from a long time ago here with us tonight, and I know for some of these young people, some of you are just names, so I'd like them to see you and meet you. Gladys, would you stand up? Our